her reserve to sing to a certain person on his birthday, but I don't think it's his birthday today. And it's around the same time of year, a little bit early perhaps. His name's Jerry Moss, and this is called Who Knows Where the Time Goes.
Started here in just a minute. Just need to find my phone cord. And connected to the Bluetooth speaker for those juicy sound drops. Okay. Where on earth did I put that stinking phone cord? Can I get it connected?
Connected.
Thank you. Alright. Okay. Open the soundboard app.
Hey, hey, hey!
Right on.
I don't know Sam Cedar.
There we go. Okay. All right. Give me another minute or two. Let's make sure I have everything ready. Turn the monitor on that down, so I will completely forget it's on. So if it doesn't suck, it doesn't suck. Alright. Can I do a pop out of this little monitor window? Oh. Using two computers, using my partner's computer. And everything is, I'm just using a guest thing. Going into everything through Safari. So. Alright. We're going to hop in to some factions. And I guess I'll have to change. Did it seriously reset all of my tags when it did that? That is just ridiculous. What is going on with my... Oh, is it switched to, Yeah, I've got these Logitech headphones. This is what's gotten me back into streaming, is having this, like, nice headphone and mic. I just couldn't take the jerry-rigged stuff anymore. I know the stream quality probably looks like junk, but it's a recapture. It's my method in lieu of a capture card or a capture box.
Sweep the area for hunters, but be careful. Move out. Copy.
Alright, I don't even know what load up I ran. Fireflies. Stand-ins. For a sort of, you know, revolutionary type. Tanky, as they might say. First, it's probably a little difficult to analyze their politics because one in the middle there sees me for sure. What are these jabronis doing? But, like, their politics are a little, you know, difficult to... Oh, man. Oof. Stayed in one spot too long. That'd be a lesson to you young revolutionaries, right? But it's like, you know, it's hard to say what their politics are, because, like, what is the representation? What are they, you know, representing? I mean, fireflies, you know, light of any kind. I don't remember their lines that they actually have in the story game. That sounded like a shot, but I couldn't tell you where that was coming from. Or where it even landed. Maybe that was my teammate? Hmm. just didn't make anything out of it. Oh man, they're all right there. I'm such a putz. Goodness gracious.
Freaking Rager.
Fireflies carrying the light of humanity. So the thing I never could get is, like, what are they resisting? Oh, what a putz. And I walked right into it though. Who is the bigger putz? The putz or the other putz who gets putzed? Double Molly. Nice. Oh my gosh, I'm such a flat-footed dope. Oh, can you stay alive, Sauce? Oh, let's see if we can get him. I mean, they gotta be like right here, right? Oh shit! That happened to me the other day too. It's like you have to, in some sense, you have to know where are they. It's gonna be followed by you getting chipped. That situational awareness, Corporal. I'm not trying to front. I don't even know which armed service that belongs in. Is that only Marines? Sorry, didn't mean to steal it. These fuckers are everywhere. Yo. Oh, come on. Yeah. Thanks. Go team. Go team. E-A-G-L-E-S. Eagles! I can't help myself. I know. I am, like, fully loaded, and I'm not even just... so slow on the uptake. Can't even do it. Always a step behind. I mean, in my defense, these people are always fucking rocking over it. That sneaky little... these guys. guys are so sneaky. Sneaky little snacks. I don't know. I don't. That was so dumb, maybe. You never know. And yeah, they just knock them out, but they gotta knock them out. And you know where they are, so, okay. They're there. They are. God damn it, that was everything I had. Yeah, the fireflies. I'm gonna say my argument is that they don't really have much of a politics. They've got a role in the story of, like, seeking a cure. Cause, like, you know, I love The Last of Us in my bones. But my only rip on it is the same rip I have on a lot of other post-apocalyptic scenarios. Is that I just don't think the world is quite fragile in this type of way. Like, humans are too valuable to even people who might control them. Watch it burn! Oh, what a little punk. Yes. Thank you. Look at me. My hand's bouncing. It's like... Oh, that is beautiful. That of an antagonist. I mean, to the story's protagonist, certainly. Oh, gosh, these motherfuckers. Let's pinch this asshole if we can. Yes, you piece of shit. Oh, come on. Come on. Get that. Get him, get him, get him, get him. Yes. Thank you. Avenged. At least I kept my armor. It's one perk of getting one to the neck. Oh no, oh no. Yeah, well. far, far away. So fuck. Oh, gosh, he's got so much junk on him. Dang. Outclassed in every way. So, what are the fireflies fighting for? I guess if you know, if we talk about like Tommy, is Tommy the fireflies? Like, are the things that we see in The Last of Us Part 2, are those the fireflies? Like that structure that's built up, that's good, that seems like the positive thing. Because if they are, it casts what happens in the first part in a different light. Because it was leading to something. But if it's not the fireflies, and then these other, I don't know if they're the saviors, I think that's the Walking Dead, right? But there's some... Oh, that was beautiful. Well done. In a row. Jabu trap house for Friday. It's the jealousy in my voice. I mean, you know. This is like a... I mean, streaming is it's completely capitalist structure and pattern. In all elements, but the most technical and sort of basic. When you're just merely talking about the technology, but even this affiliate stuff is all licensee relationships, and there's nothing. There is nothing truly cooperative about it. It's transactional. Let me get. You know what's funny is I stumbled onto. Okay, these tags were confusing me. Now I get it. Alright, so if I do just chatting, it or select a game, it will kind of limit the tags that are available to me. The content tags. I liked this idea of doing educational news, politics. I think I found some like right wing stuff. Frankly, if they're doing like a critical analysis, there's some. It seems like there's someone who's doing what I'm doing. You know, a little bit. That's maybe getting a little ahead of myself to saying I'm doing something at all. What was the other one? It was history. It was really good. Tom Paine, obviously. Educational news, politics, history. Dang, there was one other one. Anyway. Not that. You're not getting too much cord rub in that audio signal there. Yeah. Thoughts and make sure I don't have too many windows open. Oh, was that doubling? I hope that wasn't doubling the stream. Is this what I should switch now? Okay, I'm glad you're not seeing this. We're just gonna check this out for a moment. I have no. Should we peek in? What's happening? I don't even. It's just so. This person had like some anti-SJW, not Andy Milonakis, but Bad Bunny, had, you know, they were like, had some anti-SJW discussion that I couldn't follow. It wasn't arriving at a point, and it was like very abstract. So I wasn't really sure what actual side and what point was being made about the anti-SJW-ness, but in any event. Seriously, an eating stream right now? What is happening? Oh my gosh. This world. Happy Friday. To checking something like that out. First I'm gonna go to no. Alright, so this is Thomas Paine, who of course preceded Marx. But clearly there's some I think Marx has been aware of Thomas Paine, I'm sure Harvey McKay talks about that, but I don't remember. I don't think it's talked about very much in his book. So, did we last do military succession? I really don't remember. That's just... It was yesterday, but I've been just working tons since I get, you know, if I stay up a little later, I kind of get this extra time. Speaking at this point. Doesn't say to American Affairs. And of the present ability of America with some miscellaneous reflections. Which is really not... I'm not sure if that was that published originally. Oh yeah, okay, it's the appendix that it was. Okay. I mean, in all realistic terms, soon grow insolent, selected from the rest of mankind, their minds are easily poisoned by importance, and the world they act in differs so materially from the world at large that they have but little opportunity of knowing its true interests, and when they succeed to the government are frequently the most ignorant and unfit of any throughout the dominions. Another evil which attends hereditary succession is that the throne is subjected to be possessed by a minor at any age, all which time the regency acting under the cover of a king have every opportunity and inducement to betray their trust. Someday I'll get out of practice corps. 'Tis a form of government which the word of God bears testimony against, and blood will attend it. If we inquire into the business of a king, we shall find that in some countries they have none, and after sauntering away their lives without pleasure to themselves or advantage to the nation, withdraw from the scene, and leave their successors to tread the same idle ground. In absolute monarchies, the whole weight of business, civil and military, lies in the king. The children of Israel, in their request for a king, urged this plea, that he may judge us and go out before us and fight our battles. But in countries where he is neither a judge nor general, as in England, a man would be puzzled to know what
thoughts
is
on the
his
present
business.
State of American affairs.
The
right.
Nearer any government approaches,
I think I've only got like 30 minutes
business there is for a
to make it through. So we'll see
it
if
is somewhat
we'll
difficult
see if
to find
happens.
A proper name for the government of England. Sir William Meredith calls it a republic, but in its present state, it is unworthy of the name because the corrupt influence of the crown, by having the places in its disposal,
made
hath
a commitment
so efficient.
To
effectually
come to
swallowed
bed
up the power.
At 12:30.
Eaten out the virtue of, you know, the House of Commons.
But
just numbers.
Yeah, I know. That's what Sam Cedar says.
I don't know Sam Cedar.
Alright, this cheesiness is just going to continue for a long time, because I don't know how to do anything different. And how about this one?
Steel slats. Steel slats.
Maybe gotta turn it up a little bit.
Steel slats. Steel slats.
There we go. All right. I don't have pictures of Tom Paine today, but we will. Just go with what we've got. Common Sense by Thomas Paine, 1776. Thoughts on the Present State of American Affairs. In the following pages, I offer nothing more than simple facts, plain arguments, and common sense, and have no other preliminaries to settle with the reader than that he will divest himself of prejudice and prepossession, and suffer his reason and his feelings to determine for themselves that he will put on, rather, that he will not put off the true character of a man and generously enlarge his views beyond the present day. Volumes have been written on the subject of the struggle between England and America. Men of all ranks have embarked in the controversy, from different motives and with various designs. But all have been ineffectual, and the period of debate is closed. Arms, as the last resource, decide this contest. The appeal was the choice of the king, and the continent hath accepted the challenge. Wow. It hath been reported of late, Mr. Pelham, who though an able minister, was not without his faults, that on his being attacked in the House of Commons, on the score that his measures were only of a temporary kind, replied, "They will last my time." Should a thought so fatal and unmanly possess the colonies in the present contest, the name of ancestors will be remembered by future generations with detestation. The sun never shined on a cause of greater worth. 'Tis not the affair of a city, a county, a province, or a kingdom, but of a continent, of at least 1/8 part of the habitable globe. 'Tis not the concern of a day, a year, or an age. Posterity are virtually involved in the contest, and will be more or less affected, even to the end of time, by the proceedings now. Now is the seed time of continental union, faith, and honor. The least fracture now will be like a name engraved with the point of a pin on the tender rind of a young oak. The wound will enlarge with the tree, and posterity read it in full-grown characters. By referring the matter from argument to arms, a new era for politics is struck. A new method of thinking hath arisen. All plans, proposals, etc., prior to the 19th of April, i.e., the commencement of hostilities, are like the almanacs of the last year, which, though proper then, are superseded and useless now. Whatever was advanced by the advocates on either side of the question then, terminated in one and the same point. Viz. A union with Great Britain. The only difference between the parties was the method of effecting it, the one proposing force, the other friendship, but it hath so far happened that the first hath failed, and the second hath withdrawn her influence. As much hath been said of the advantages of reconciliation, which, like an agreeable dream, hath passed away and left us as we were, it is but right that we should examine the contrary side of the argument, and inquire into some of the many material injuries which these colonies sustain, and always will sustain, by being connected with and dependent on Great Britain. To examine that connection and dependence, on the principles of nature and common sense, to see what we have to trust to if separated, and what we are to expect if dependent. I have heard it asserted by some that as America hath flourished under her former connection with Great Britain, that the same connection is necessary towards her future happiness, and will always have the same effect. Nothing can be more fallacious than this kind of argument. We may as well assert that because a child has thrived upon milk, that it is never to have meat, or that the first 20 years of our lives is to become a precedent for the next 20. But even this is admitting more than is true, for I answer roundly that America would have flourished as much, and probably much more, had no European power had anything to do with her. The commerce by which she hath enriched herself are the necessaries of life, and will always have a market while eating is the custom of Europe. But she has protected us, say some. That she has engrossed us is true, and defended the continent at our expense, as well as her own, is admitted, and she would have defended Turkey from the same motive, viz. The sake of trade and dominion. Alas, we have been long led away by ancient prejudices, and made large sacrifices to superstition. We have boasted the protection of Great Britain, without considering that her motive was interest, not attachment, that she did not protect us from our enemies on our account, but from her enemies on her own account, from those who had no quarrel with us on any other account, and who will always be our enemies on the same account. Let Britain waive her pretensions to the continent, or the continent throw off the dependence, and we should be at peace with France and Spain were they at war with Britain. The miseries of Hanover last war ought to warn us against connections. It has lately been asserted in Parliament that the colonies have no relation to each other, but through the parent country, that Pennsylvania and the Jerseys, and so on for the rest, are sister colonies by the way of England. This is certainly a very roundabout way of proving relationship, but it is the nearest and only true way of proving enemyship, if I may so call it. France and Spain never were, nor perhaps ever will be our enemies as Americans, but as our being the subjects of Great Britain. I'm just pausing on a moment to ponder if that is, that very last phrase has proven true or not. I mean, I think in like an obvious level, yes, it has proved true, but to what extent have France and Spain been our enemies as Americans? I mean, I'm just showing my drawing a blank on history. I mean, clearly conflicts with Spanish colonial interests. That happened. So I think that was premature. That was premature. But this kind of maybe debases the text a little bit to insert what I'm about to say, but I feel like it's not without merit to nearly replace references to Great Britain as kind of colony in a nation, imperialism, thus capitalism. That's what should be thought of as the revolt, the structure to be revolted against. I think there's something there. It's a very, how should I say, inchoate thought, but I think there's something there. But Britain is the parent country, say some. Then the more shame upon her conduct. Even brutes do not devour their young, nor savages make war upon their families. Wherefore the assertion, if true, turns to her reproach. But it happens not to be true, or only partly so, in the phrase parent or mother country hath been Jesuitically adopted by the king and his parasites with a low papistical design of gaining an unfair bias on the credulous weakness of our minds. Europe, and not England, is the parent country of America. This new world hath been the asylum for the persecuted lovers of civil and religious liberty from every part of Europe. Hither have they fled, not from the tender embraces of the mother, but from the cruelty of the monster, and it is so far true of England that the same tyranny which drove the first emigrants from home pursues their descendants still. I mean, my God. As one might say. It's my sheet. That's my also my inchoate Zizek impression, which just comes off as him having an orgasm, which is a completely disgusting thought I've just incepted into your brain. Sorry, not sorry. All right. I didn't advertise this to anybody because I didn't know if it was going to happen. I didn't even post that I'm on. You know, I don't know what kind of notifications people get. None that they're eating. You know, except these folks who, it's hard to know. I mean, I don't know. Maybe this is just, this is adding to my viewer count. As much as I'm, you know, critical of pressure to become affiliate, I don't care if people become affiliate. It doesn't bother me. I don't think I have the. We'll see. I don't think my life just changes a lot. As much as it is. Remains the same. It just always something always has to shift around, because kids get older, there's something happened with the house, the job. It's just like, goodness gracious, where's the time for my social reproduction and for that of my family, first and foremost? Goodness gracious, I mean, I think I can telegraph some, you know, just default selfishness that I'm a product of my space. You know, I have to own that. I can't just like say that I'm passively acting out the sum of my experiences and pressures and stresses and all that. But, you know, it's real. It's real. It's hard to break out of constant, you know, but kind of push and pull. It's definitely very difficult, very difficult to square that circle. I mean, this stuff about immigrants and the cruelty of the monster, I mean, it's just such a muddled story now, because it's the U.S. that is in a very real way the cruel monster. I mean, these immigrants who are oh, is that that might be my child. Hang on. I don't think it is. But these, from Guatemala and Honduras are you know, the kind of collapse of local infrastructure and, you know, the dominance of armed gangs or paramilitary forces. That have come into control as the result of coups against, you know, more like pink tide center left governments, who may have had corruption issues, but their main crime was questioning the property power and control and resource control. Is my feeling about it. And pursues their descendants still. I mean, this is heavy stuff. It still rings true. Is that? I think I might have to call it.
today. I feel like pleasing you more than before. Today, I know what I wanna do, but I don't know what for. To be living for you is all I want to do. To be loving you, it'll all be there when my dreams come true. Today, you're making me say that I somehow have changed. Today, you look into my eyes, I'm just not the same. To be any more than all I am would be a lie. I'm so full of love, I could burst upon. Today, everything you want, I swear, it all will come true. Today, I realize how much I'm in love with you. With you standing here, I could tell the world what it means to love. To go on from here, I can't use words, they don't